Hello students, today we are going to study fourth chapter from Hornbill book of 11th class. Name of the chapter is Landscape of the Soul. This is written by Nathalie Trevray. First of all, I would like to give a brief introduction about the chapter. This chapter is about how different the Chinese art form is from the European art form. The writer uses two stories to make a contrast. European art is about reproducing an actual view, whereas Chinese art is about not creating a real landscape. European art is an artist's way to let viewers show exactly what he wants them to see in the landscape. Chinese art is the artist's spiritual and inner voice, where you can travel from any point and it let the viewers create a path for their imagination. Let us read the chapter. Para by para, I will tell you the meaning. A wonderful old tale is told about the painter Wu Daoji, who lived in the 8th century. His last painting was a landscape assigned by the Tang Emperor Xuanzong to decorate a palace wall. Palace means castle, mahal. The master held had hidden his work behind a screen, so only the emperor would see it. For a long while, the emperor admired the wonderful scene. Admired means appreciated. Wonderful means surprising, awesome. Discovering forests, high mountains, waterfalls, clouds floating in an immense sky. Immense means very big. Men on hilly paths, birds in flight, looks up, said the painter. In this cave, at the foot of the mountain, dwells a spirit. Dwells means lives, rehta hai. The painter clapped his hands and the entrance to the cave opened. The inside is splendid. Splendid means awesome, very surprising, shandar, beyond anything words can convey. Please let me show your majesty the way. Majesty is a word that is spoken to the kings or the judges, etc., to give honor them. The painter entered the cave, but the entrance closed behind him. And before the astonished emperor could move or utter a word, utter means speak, the painting had vanished. Vanished means disappeared from the wall. Not a trace of Wu Daoji's brush was left, and the artist was never seen again in this world. It is told landscape of the soul. Landscape means any landscape, just like mountain, earth, part of earth. Soul means atma. So atma ka landscape. This means this story is about a spiritual one. So here is also told one story about the painter Wu Daoji. Where did he live? He lived in the, in which century did he live? He lived in 18th century. It was his last painting. This assignment to make a painting was given by Xuanzong, named emperor, and it was his last painting, Wu Daoji's last painting. The painter hid his work behind the screen, so the only emperor would see it. The emperor, upon looking at the painting, appreciated many things into that painting. Which type of things? Like discovering forests, high mountains, waterfall, floating clouds, men going on hilly paths, and birds in flight. The painter then made him look at a cave in the painting, which was at the foot of the mountain, and compared it with a living spirit. As the painter clapped his hands, the entrance of the cave opened, and he let the emperor know how beautiful the inside of the cave was, and he asked him to show all this to him. The painter entered the cave. The entrance closed behind him. The emperor could not enter the cave, as the emperor was greatly surprised. The painting disappeared from the wall. After that, the painter was never seen. Now you will say, ma'am, how it is possible in painting, how did he vanish? But beta, this is a story. This is a story which is the which plays an important role in China's classical education. So it is a story, and this is the mind of the painter. Such stories played an important part in China's classical education. The books of Confucius and Zhuangzi are full of them. They help the master to guide his disciple in the right direction. Beyond the anecdote, they are deeply revealing of the spirit in which art was considered. Contrast this story or another famous one about a painter who wouldn't draw the eye of a dragon he had painted for fear it would fly out of the painting, with an old story from my native Flanders that I find most representative of Western painting. Disciple means shishya, student, a follower. Anecdote, a short interesting story of a real person. Flanders means medieval country in Western Europe. Representative of Western painting. These stories play an important part in China. Similarly, like the books of Confucius and Zhuangzi are full of such stories, as they help the master to guide in the right direction. These stories were considered to be deeply revealing of the spirit, just like art. There are another famous story in contrast to the previous one, where the painter wouldn't paint the eye of a dragon. He feared that the dragon would fly out from the painting. It was one of the stories from many others which came from a medieval country in Western Europe. In 15th century, Antwerp, a master blacksmith called Quentin Matthies fell in love with a painter's daughter. The father would not accept a son-in-law in such a profession, so Quentin sneaked into the painter's studio and painted a fly on his latest panel. Latest means very new. With his delicate realism, means that was looking very true. Delicate realism means quality of art that makes it seem real. That the master tried to sweat it away. Sweat means hit or crash, smashing. मतलब मारना चाहा उसे या उड़ाना चाहा. Before he realized what had happened, Quentin was immediately means तुरंत admitted as an apprentice into his studio. Apprentice means trainee, as a trainee. These two stories, he married his beloved and went on to become one of the most famous painters of his age. These two stories illustrate what each form of art is trying to achieve: a perfect illusionistic likeness in Europe, the essence of inner life and secret in Asia. Antwerp, it is a city in north do north. During the 15th century in Antwerp, a master blacksmith named Quentin Matthies falls in love with a painter's daughter. Since the father was not accepting their relationship because of his profession, the blacksmith sneaked, means chupchap ghus gaya, into the painter's studio and painted a fly on his latest panel. The painting was so real that the master tried to hit the fly away, thinking that it was real. Before he realized that it was just a painting, the blacksmith was accepted into the studio as a trainee. He married the painter's daughter and later became one of the famous painters of his age. The two stories told above are trying to illustrate the form of art in two different regions. In Europe, the art is perfect and like an illusion which resembles something. In Asia, the art gives an essence of inner life and spirit. In the Chinese story, the emperor commissions a painting and appreciates its outer appearance, but the artist reveals to him the true meaning of his work. The emperor may rule over the territory he has conquered. Conquered means jeetna, jeet liya jise. But only the artist knows the way within. Let me show the way. The Tao, a word that means both the path or the method. The mysterious work of the universe, the painting is gone. But the artist has reached the goal, his goal beyond any material appearance. As in the Chinese story, the artist reveals the true meaning of his work to the emperor who rules over his territory but did not know the way within. Means उसे आत्मा का रास्ता नहीं पता, आत्मा का रास्ता जहाँ जब परमात्मा से मिलते हैं. मीन्स दिस इज ए स्पिरिचुअल स्टोरी यू कैन से. द एम्परर ओनली सॉ द आउटर अपियरेंस ऑफ द वॉल पेंटिंग. द वर्क वॉज मिस्टीरियस एंड द टाओ विच मीन्स समथिंग विच हैज बोथ पास्ट is what the artist did. As the painting was gone, after the artist reached the cave, the motive was fulfilled and that some work is beyond material appearance. Means that was spiritual work beyond materialistic world. A classical Chinese landscape is not meant to reproduce an actual view, as would a Western figurative painting, whereas the European painter wants you to borrow his eyes and look at a particular landscape exactly as he saw it. From a specific angle, the Chinese painter does not choose a single viewpoint. His landscape is not a real one and you can enter it from any point, then travel in it. The artist creates a path for your eyes to travel up and down, then back again in a leisurely movement. Leisurely means comfortable movement. This is even more true in the case of the horizontal scroll, in which the action of slowly opening one action of the painting, then rolling it up to move on to the other, adds a dimension of time which is unknown in any other form of painting. It also requires the active participation of the viewer, who decides at what pace, means speed, he will travel through the painting, a participation which is physical as well as mental. The Chinese painter does not want you to borrow his eyes, he wants you to enter his mind. The landscape is an inner one and spiritual and conceptual space. Figurative painting is metaphoric representation of art. Leisurely means unhurried or relaxed. Conceptual space, relation with an abstract representation. The Chinese landscape painting is not made with a real viewpoint, but it is a representation of the artist's thought. Means we have to enter in the mind of an artist. The Western painting in Europe is a figurative art form. मीन्स जैसी ये दिखती है वैसी ही होती है. द यूरोपियन पेंटर पेंट्स ए लैंडस्केप टू शो यू ए स्पेसिफिक सीन ऑफ द लैंडस्केप, वेर इज द चाइनीज पेंटर डजंट चूज ए रियल व्यू पॉइंट. यू कैन एंटर द पेंटिंग फ्रॉम एनी पॉइंट एंड कैन ट्रेवल एनी वेयर वेर योर थॉट्स एंड इमेजिनेशन टेक यू. द चाइनीज आर्टिस्ट वॉन्ट्स यू टू ट्रेवल बाई क्रिएटिंग यूर ओन पाथ and then come out in a relaxed moment. In China, mode of seeing a painting is more enjoyable. A horizontal scroll is a form where one section of the painting is opened one by one by rolling it up to move on the other side. It creates a dimension which is not practiced in any other form of art form. It requires both mental and physical participation of the viewer. The Chinese painter wants you to enter his mind and see the painting from his thoughts. The landscape created by Chinese artists is spiritual, inner and conceptual or abstract space. This concept is expressed as sensui, literally mountain water, which used together represent the world landscape. More than two elements of an image, these represent two complementary poles, reflecting the Taoist view of the universe. The mountain is yang, reaching vertically towards heaven, stable, warm and dry in the sun, while the water is yin, horizontal and resting on the earth, fluid, moist and cool. The interaction of yin, the conceptive receptive feminine aspect of universal energy and its counterpart yang, active and masculine, is of course a fundamental notion of Taoism. Notion means view. What is often overlooked is an essential third element. Essential means important. The middle void where their interaction takes place. This can be compared with the yogic practice of pranayama. Breathe in, retain, breathe out. The suspension of breath is the void where meditation occurs. The middle void is essential. Nothing can happen without it. Hence the importance of the void unpainted space in Chinese landscape. Taoism, this is a Chinese philosophy based on the writing of Lao Tzu. Void means empty, I told you, vacant. The Chinese concept of art is also expressed as sensui, which also means mountain water. It is used together to represent the world landscape. The two complementary poles of an image reflect the Taoist view. The mountain in the landscape is yang, which means to reach vertically towards heaven, stable, warm and dry in the sun. Whereas the water is the yin, which is receptive and feminine aspect of universal energy. The yang is active and masculine, and the opposite of yin. There is a third essential element, which is a middle void, this is called where they interact. This middle void can be compared to pranayama, which means to breathe in, retain and breathe out. Here the suspension of the breath is the void. In this meditation process, it is an essential part as nothing can happen without it. Hence, the white unpainted space in Chinese landscape is equally important. Means anyone can imagine according to their mind for this white space. This is also where man finds a fundamental role in that space between heaven and earth. He becomes the conduit of communication between both poles of the universe. His presence is essential even if it is only suggested, far from being lost or oppressed by the lofty peaks. He is, in Cheng's wonderful expression, the eye of the landscape. Conduit means tube. Oppressed means burdened, worried. Lofty means tall or high. The middle void, middle space, is where a man finds an important role. Man is the channel of communication in the space between heaven and the earth. Means man is the mediator of communication between heaven and the earth. which are the two poles of the universe. Man's presence is essential. It is not being lost or suppressed due to the high peaks, but he is the eye of the landscape. When French painter Jean Dufet mooted the concept of art brut in 1940s, the art of the untrained visionary was of minority interest. From its almost build means covered, beginnings, outsider art has gradually become the fastest growing area of interest in contemporary art internationally. Gradually means slowly. French painter Jean Dufet first created the concept of art brut or art raw art in the 1940s. Then the art of the untrained visionary was of minority interest. The outsider art has gradually became the fastest growing area of interest in international modern art. This genre is described as the art of those who have no right to be artists, as they have received no formal training, yet show talent and artistic insight. Their works are a stimulating contrast to a lot of mainstream offerings. This particular type of work is the creation of those who have no right to be artists, as they have received no formal training, yet they showed their talent and artistic insight. Let us see this garden. This is a raw garden. This is made by nature, who didn't get any formal training for any art form, but he created this with the best material, and it is so beautiful. It is now situated in Chandigarh. You can see it, and he had made it without any help with the waste material. Every type of waste material has been used in it, and he did it alone. The work of around the time Dufet was propounding his concept in India, an untutored genius was creating paradise. Paradise means swarg, heaven. Years ago, the little patch of jungle that he began clearing to make himself a garden sculpted with stone and recycled material is known to the world today as the Raw Garden at Chandigarh. The work of its 80-year-old creator, director Nechan, is now hailed as India's biggest contributor to outsider art. The 50th issue of Raw Vision, a UK-based magazine pioneer in outsider art publications, features Nechan and his raw garden sculpture, Women by the Waterfall, on its anniversary issues cover. The notion of art brut and raw art was of works that were in their raw state as regards cultural and artistic influences. Anything and everything from a tin to a sink to a broken down car could be material for a work of art. Something Nechan has taken to dizzying heights. Recognizing his art as an outstanding testimony means witness, gawah, of the difference a single man can make when he lives his dream, the Swiss Commission for UNESCO will be honoring him by way of a European exposition of his works. The 5 months interactive show Realm of Nature beginning October will be held at leading museums in Switzerland, Belgium, France, Italy. The biggest reward is walking through the garden and seeing people enjoy my creation, Nature said. Now, the work of 80-year-old Nechan is India's biggest contribution to outsider art. He has made a garden sculpted with stone and recycled material. It is known, you can see in the picture, these are the made by nature. These are the pictures of men and women, and he has made so many animals statue also with the best material, recycled material and with stone. It is known to the world today as the Rock Garden at Chandigarh. The recently released 50th scene of Raw Vision, a UK-based magazine pioneer is in outsider art publication, features Nekchand and his rock garden sculpture remain by the waterfall. On its anniversary issues cover, his art has been recognized as an outstanding testimony of the difference a single man can make when he lives his dream. The Swiss Commission for UNESCO will be honoring him by way of a 5-month interview, interactive show of his work. Nekchand says that walking through the garden and watching people enjoy his creation is the biggest reward for him. Means नेक्स्ट ये कहना चाहते हैं कि उसका सबसे बड़ा रिवॉर्ड, जो ये सब रिवॉर्ड्स मिल रहे हैं ये उसके सामने कुछ भी नहीं है, उसका सबसे बड़ा रिवॉर्ड क्या है कि लोग उसके गार्डन में घूमते हैं और वो एंजॉय करते हैं, तो यही उसके लिए सबसे बड़ा रिवॉर्ड है. दिस इज ऑल स्टूडेंट्स, दिस चैप्टर इज लिटिल बिट डिफिकल्ट, बट आई थिंक इफ यू लिसन इट ट्वाइस और थ्राइस यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड इट वेल. दिस इज ऑल. थैंक यू फॉर वॉचिंग द वीडियो.